it's holy fox here. This is my face. Isn't it a glorious face? Yeah. So right now you're probably like, why can I see you? Why would anybody want to see me? But yeah. These are actually going to be like regular videos every Friday, I guess. Yeah, every Friday these are going to go up. This one's going up. Well, I'm recording this on Tuesday because I will be gone starting tomorrow, so I have to record this one early, but after this it'll be fine. On a normal basis, I'll probably actually like bother to wear makeup, but I didn't bother to put it on because I'm really lazy today. It's just not my day to be activitied, I guess. To have activities. No, this is the thing. Like, you're gonna meet the weird me, because I'm weird. I don't do anything normally. And you're about to find out by having these one-on-one talks with me. The reason mostly why I'm doing this is because I'm trying to start losing weight, and by talking here, this is a good way of motivating me, just talking about, like, how it's going and stuff, and I don't know, it's just a little fun thing, and just talking about, like, anything that's gone on during the week, anything with videos, which, yeah, videos, where have those been? There's only one simple explanation I can give. And it's actually the true explanation. I'm sorry, there's a window right there, and there's a dog running around outside. One of those, those Dobermans. Yeah, it's a Doberman. One of the neighbors has a Doberman. And, so basically, I'm watching the dog run around in the yard with the neighbor outside. But anyways, let's see, what do I want to tell you? About videos. Okay, so, about a month and a half ago, I started taking antidepressants, but, they made me really ill when I first started taking them. Like, I felt like I was gonna throw up a lot, and, because of that, I wasn't really motivated to work on videos at that time. And things were finally starting to go back to normal, and then I had, like, my 1 month checkup, and I was explaining to my doctor that they work, they just weren't working long enough, and she put me on a stronger dose, and I got sick all over again, and now I'm better, but since I'm gonna be gone, I can't really do anything. So as soon as I come back from this, I will be working on videos again. I'm very sorry that I haven't been working on videos. I actually have, like, all of the recordings that we've done so far for World of Warcraft on my laptop so that I can take that with me and work on videos while I'm gone for that. At least, like, edit those so that they're out of the way and I can start working on .hack. Because the biggest thing is, I shouldn't have given myself a deadline to do post-game for .hack, because the problem is that .hack, okay, how do I say this nicely? There's a lot of stuff in post-game, like, we're talking a lot of stuff, and, the problem is that post-game, there's so much stuff to do, like, collect all the items, do all the bike missions, do all the mecha grunty, lucky animals, the PK stuff. In this one, you got the lost weapons, and, like, there's so much stuff you gotta do. And the biggest problem is the item collection and opening, like, treasure chests. Because they're, like, two separate things. And the treasure chest one is not so bad, because you just go to a random area and open treasure chests and it counts. But the item collection, you actually have to collect, like, if not all of, like, 100% of all items, it's, like, 90% or something, and biggest problem is that most of those, to get them, you have to go and you have to go to aerial words, and most of the time you don't have the aerial words that you need for that, and you have to go to other aerial words, and you have to get a certain rank in the field. Like, sometimes you have to get, like, a D rank. Like, how do I know when to get a D rank? I mean, I know now because I've looked up so much information, but it's like, how is someone else supposed to know, like, what's the definition of getting a D rank? And in case you ever wanted to know, you just gotta, like, go to an open field, kick all the barrels, and you'll get a D rank. Don't open any treasure chests, just kick all the barrels. Don't fight any monsters, if you can do that. Just kick all the barrels, and then you'll get a D-ring. And it's like, yeah, I totally would have known to do that. But, yes, I'm gonna take a sip of my tea. Do you like my heart mug? Yeah. I've been wanting to get, like, a regular tea mug. They have these ones that have, like, little animals in the side of them, and I wanted to get the one with the fox, because holy fox, and, yeah. They have one with a bear, and bears are actually my favorite animal, but I'm not gonna do that. So, yeah. I'm trying to think of something interesting for you. I completed my Pokedex in Pokemon X and Y. In my Pokemon X, I completed it, and I'm very proud of myself because I'm, like, a completionist. Like, right now, I'm going through, and any Pokemon that I don't have, like, a form of, like, right now I have Celio and Walrein, but I don't have Spheal. So I need to go and make a baby of Spheal, but at the same time, I'm also trying to get a shiny Furfro now that I have the shiny charm. So, yeah. I really like Furfro. I think it's my favorite Pokemon of this gen, and it's the only one I don't have a shiny of. Like, I have a shiny Deanie, I have shiny Larvesta, well, I got that Larvesta in this game, and I have a shiny, the evolution. I think it's, Volcani, no, because I keep getting it mixed up with that new legendary, Volcarona, no, I don't know. I keep getting that new legendary that they announced, the one that goes with Diancie and Hoopa, and I get this now mixed up, and it's really sad, because that's one of my favorite Pokemon, because I'm a big fanatic of Godzilla. I used to watch Godzilla when I was a kid, all the time. My dog is down here. I used to watch Godzilla all the time when I was a kid, and Mothra was my favorite, and every time I get that Pokemon, I always name it Mothra. Like, my Larvesta, my shiny Larvesta's name is Mothra, even though I think the regular form looks more like Mothra. But, you know what the saddest thing that I had was, I was trying to get, I think it was a shiny Esper. My friend got me a shiny Esper now, but I wanted a shiny Esper before, and, I was in a safari, and it had Grumpig, Esper, and Girafarig in it. And I wanted Grumpig or Esper, because Grumpig, it's so underappreciated, but I really like it. It was one of my favorites from Gen 3. And, I got shiny Girafarig, and the only difference is, like, the pink on, I think it's hooves. I know on its nose. I think it's the nose and the hooves that are pink. That's the only thing that's different. It's blue. I was very disappointed. And so about the completion of the Pokedex, you don't have the typical thing in any Pokemon game is you don't have to get the event Pokemon. Like, they don't count towards Pokedex, like last gen's Meloetta, Genesect, and Keldeo. They don't count. You can go without getting them, and it won't count towards your Pokedex completion. Because, you know, if you miss an event, that's not your fault. So, I'm not good enough for that. Well, I mean, like, I'm good enough for it, but I'm a completionist through and through. And the biggest problem was my Pokemon Y has been missing for, like, I don't know, 2 months now. We don't really talk about it because I'm pretty upset that it's missing, because it has, like, half of my shinies from my previous generations in there. But it also had my event Pokemon in it. And not that that's a bad thing, but it also had all my stuff from my last game. So, like, I had to replay White 2 recently. And I basically had to get all the Pokemon over, and I wanted to get most of them as shinies, except you can't get Reshiram, Zekrom, and Kyurem as shinies. So that was out. But I got all the rest of them as shinies, and I was really proud of myself. And I got Latias as a shiny, even though I think Latias is really ugly as a shiny because I hate the color yellow. I hate the colors yellow and orange. But yeah, so I got all 718 Pokemon now, including the event Pokemon. Thank you to 4 of my friends for doing that. They were really amazing. They helped me out a lot. My one friend gave me most of the legendaries from the previous games, which was really awesome, because I was really excited about that. And, my other friend helped me basically get Pokemon that were floating around, like regular Pokemon, which was a lot of Pokemon, so that was really nice of him to do. And then I had, my one friend, he helped me get, like, Landorus and all them, because a lot of ways to get them is through the Dream Radar, and I didn't even finish that. So I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going back now and I'm doing the Dream Radar. I started it over because I had, like, the first one, the green guy. I forgot which one he is. And, I'm going back and doing that now. And that's not that much fun, but that's okay. I'm going back and I'm, so he helped me get those, including, Kyurem and Zekrom at the time, because, and maybe even Reshiram, I'm not sure, but, like, at the time I didn't have my Black 2 finished. Like, this was last week that I finished that, and, hey, look, the dog's in the background. Nope, this way. The dog's in the background. The mirror's, like, or the camera's reversed, so over here is, like, one way, over here is a different way. But yeah, so, dog, she likes looking out the windows, so she's just wandering around like a weirdo. And, so besides that, trying to think. So after, besides that, my other friend, she helped me get, like, the last few that I was missing, so that was pretty amazing. And that was pretty awesome. So my Pokedex is complete. I've officially have all 718 Pokemon. So happy. I'm going through now and I'm replaying my old games because I lost all the information because my sister restarted all of my games. Like my Pearl, my Diamond, my Platinum, my Heart Gold, my Soul Silver, my Leaf Green, my Emerald, you know, like, all of them, like, including the 5th gen. She restarted gen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm like, oh god, no. So, yeah, I'm currently going back and doing that. What else? I think that's really it, in the word of Pokemon, at least. Let's see. Pokemon collection-wise, if you look at the binders, like the one, that teal one that says Pokemon Center, New York. I don't know if you can see it, but the binders from there down are all Pokemon cards that I've collected over the years because I love Pokemon, and I've loved Pokemon for the longest time. Like, my most valued treasure is my Pokemon Green. Actually, I have it right here. Let's see. My Pokemon Green is one of my most valued gifts that I've ever had. I value it very dearly. I had the game when I was younger, but I lost it, which makes me really sad. And one year when I was at MagFest, actually, I found someone who was selling it, and he was only selling it for $28. And I was like, give me now. So I've had it ever since. I just keep it in my SP, which is very old. I'm actually surprised it even works. Most of the time now, the battery's pretty much drained. After about 2 hours, you have to plug it in, because it's like, oh god, battery, what's that? Yeah. So other than that, in the forms of getting healthier, me and my fiance have now realized how expensive it is to stay healthy. Like, right now we're starting to buy like a lot of fruits and stuff, but we have a farmer's market by us, so it's really easy for us to get like a lot of fruit for a good deal. Like, we got strawberries, and it was in a basket about this big, and it was like this wide, and it was really, sorry, I get very distracted when the windows are open, so I should keep those closed more often, but, it was a very good deal. It was like $10. But if I went to the grocery store, I'd get, like, a carton, like, this big and, like, this long for, like, $8. And it's like, how? Like, if you had a big family, how do you have, how can you be healthy? Like, why would a family of, like, four people go to the grocery store and get that little tiny thing for $8 when they could go buy like two bags of chips for $8? Like, it's so much easier to be unhealthy. It's so sad. Like, that's the saddest thing, is it's so easy to be unhealthy nowadays because it's so expensive to be healthy. Like, you know, Whole Foods and all that is always known for their organics, but they are so expensive that you walk in there and your, like, wallet is already hurting by just walking in. So it's really hard. It's not so hard for us because there's only two people, but, like, I can't imagine, like, a big family trying to do that. So, yeah. We've started doing, like, walking once a day because the dog really likes to go on walks. She gets really excited if you even mention the word, but she's so tired that she's not acknowledging it right now. But, yeah, we started doing that as a form of, like, just getting out and getting exercise, because I can't do a lot of heavy exercising, so I have to be really careful. But, it's pretty good. I know it's gonna be a really slow process, because, like I said, I can't do any heavy stuff because I could injure myself really easily because of some things. But, yeah, really hoping that this is the wake-up call for me. Pretty much at this point, like, I recently was, like, having a bunch of problems with my liver and stuff, and one of the easiest ways to make the problems at least a little bit more manageable is to start losing some weight. So I'm really hoping that this will be a wake-up call for me finally. Like, when I was younger, I had very low self-esteem problems. Like, now I don't really care. I'm like, whatever. You don't like me because I'm overweight? I mean, so what? I'm just a person. I'm just a little bit bigger. But I try to be such a nice person that I hope it makes up for the fact that I'm, you know, luckily I have someone who sees past all that. But, basically, yeah, I'm trying to get used to, like, eating the proper portions and just getting motivated to go out and walk and exercise and stuff. And that's not so bad right now. I'm pretty motivated to go out and walk because since I work from home, it's a nice refresher to just get up and get away from, like, the computer for a while, because I feel like it's so easy for me to overwork myself because I'm because I work from home. Like, a lot of people are like, oh, you're so lucky you work from home. But, like, for me, I'm an artist for a living, if you don't know. And it's really hard for me. Like, a lot of times my sleeping schedule gets very askew because I work with people all over the place. So, like, sometimes I'll have a meeting at, like, 3 a.m. because that for people in Japan, that's, like, what, 5 p.m.? So it's not a big deal for them, but for me it is. So basically, yeah, that's a thing that is needing to be fixed really bad. So just getting out is very good. I mean, I used to get a lot of problems with depression because I would never get out, but I feel like this, like, walking once a day is really helping with that, so I'm really glad that I'm doing this. So yeah, let's wish me luck. I have about 100 pounds that I need to lose. It's not exactly 100 pounds, but it's, like, right there. So yeah, I'm really hoping that this will be good. I'm more than happy to talk about my current weight just because, I want to, like, tell you guys how much I lose all the time. But I'm gonna take a drink first because my tea, I don't want it to get cold. It's already starting to get a little cold, but that's okay. I'll drink the rest after. It's like my morning tea because I don't drink coffee because coffee's really gross to me. But yeah, so right now I'm 276 and I need my healthy weight is 180, so I'm pretty much like 100 pounds need to lose, but I'm pretty helpful. Like, my fiance has been really supportive. He works out occasionally, so he keeps in pretty good shape, and he's been walking with me and stuff to try and help motivate me to lose the weight and everything. So yeah, it's really, hopeful, and that's pretty much it. So, thank you guys for listening to me ramble. I will see you guys on Friday after I get back from Anime North in Toronto, and, yeah, Canada, be prepared, because I'm coming for you. Yeah, okay. So, anyways, I will talk to you guys soon. Take care, everyone, and bye!